Percy had never known Tom Tipper to be anything but cheerful. Tom was postman on Thomas's branch, and every morning he would have a cheery word for Percy as he helped to load the mailbags onto the train day and night. Percy then took them to the town, where there was a big office for sorting the letters. But one morning, Tom wasn't there. A postman they didn't know just dumped the bags on the platform and bicycled off without stopping to help. What's happened to Tom? Wondered Percy. And his old van, added his driver. No wonder the new chap looks fed up carrying mailbags on a bike would make anyone miserable. Tom was soon back, but without his van. During my illness, the postmaster had decided that the van was too expensive to run, he said sadly. The rounds now take longer on my bike. Poor Tom was no longer cheerful, and now had no time to help load the train. I wish I could cheer Tom Tipper up, sighed Percy the small engine. He wondered how this might be done. One day, as Percy was waiting to leave, a man came from the station office to tell Tom that some papers needed signing for the Fat Controller. Oh dear, said Tom anxiously, this is going to make me very late. He asked Percy and his driver to keep an eye on his bike while he was gone. He was gone a long time, and Percy began to worry. I hope he comes soon, he said. I'm going to be late myself. He still hadn't returned as the signal dropped, and Percy was ready to go.
Come on, Percy, called his driver. It's time to go now.
But Tom's not back yet, cried Percy.
Sorry, Percy, said his driver. We must be off. Time and the Fat Controller wait for no man.
In the flurry of starting, no one knew that Tom had carelessly propped his bike against Percy's mail trucks. Percy soon started away, the bicycle swerved beneath Percy's mail trucks, and disappeared with a crunch. Percy's driver stopped the train quickly. Everyone came running to the scene. Tom Tipper's bicycle was in pieces and beyond repair.
I'm sorry, Mr. Tipper, apologised Percy.
Never mind, Percy, said the postman. It wasn't your fault, and I never liked that bike much anyway. But now I've only got my legs to get the mail delivered. Whatever will happen next?
Tom Tipper soon found out. When the Fat Controller heard about the accident, he ordered that Tom should be provided with a new bicycle at once. But next morning, Percy arrived at Farquhar as usual. Beep, beep, he whistled. As he arrived, he saw a brand new, smart red van standing in the yard. Close by stood Tom Tipper, beaming from ear to ear.
That accident did me a good turn, Percy, he smiled. And now, my chief has decided to let me have a new van after all. Much better than another bike, and now I can always be on time again.
Tom Tipper was right. He happily trundles on time around the island of Sodor, delivering letters and parcels to each destination. Always happy to collect letters and parcels from both Thomas and Percy's mail trucks. He is once again cheerful, often thanks Percy for helping him.
So I did help after all, said Percy to himself, but by accident, as you might say.
I believe Tom Tipper could only agree.
Accidentally, of course. Don't you think so?